Let's revisit the island or the universe that only has a farmer and a builder in it. And let's think about a different scenario. Let's think about a scenario where they each start off with a lot of physical currency, or we're in a universe that starts off with much more physical currency than the last example, where the whole universe only had 4 gold coins. So let's say that the farmer right over here starts off with, and I'll write down the number instead of drawing the coins. Let's say he starts off with 5. Actually, let me draw the coins. That's kind of fun. So let's say he starts off with 5 gold coins, and the builder also starts off with 5 gold coins. But entering into this year, the farmer is feeling pretty pessimistic. And so he goes to the builder, and he tells builder, look, I just want the base level of construction or maintenance or whatever going on my farm today. I can only afford 1 coin of business from you, or what you can do for 1 coin. So he gives that coin to the builder. Now, the builder's feeling pretty pessimistic. Normally, the farmer starts off the year much better than that. He says, this is clearly going to be a bad year. So I'm only going to buy my base necessities for food. So he goes to the farmer and says, look, even though I have, you know, he's not going to tell the farmer that he's hoarding all of this cash, but he's going to say, look, farmer, things are bad, business is bad, I'm preparing for the worst, just give me the base minimum, cheapest, simplest food you can that'll keep me alive. And so he only gives 1 coin back to the farmer. Now, imagine that the money supply actually increases. For whatever reason, the farmer digs around in his backyard and finds some more gold. And then the builder also, while building a building, actually discovers a huge chest of gold right over here. But they're still feeling pretty pessimistic. Maybe they're just pessimistic people. And so the farmer, despite this increase in the money supply, this gold that he discovers, he's like, you know, how frequently am I going to discover gold like that? That was just a one-off thing, a bonanza that I just happened to run into. The business itself is pretty bad. So and it was even worse last year than it normally is. So I'm going to spend as little as possible. So I'm going to go to the builder, and I'm going to say, look, things have seem to only be getting worse. I can only afford half a coin worth of what you have to offer, but for this base maintenance. And the builder's thinking, well, gee, you know, that's even worse than last year, but I have all of this extra capacity. I could be building so much more. I have people who aren't working. Sure, I'll take it. I'll take your half coin, and I'll deliver that same service. I'll deliver the same service for that half of a coin. And so he does it. And so essentially, his price has gone down despite the fact that there's more currency. And so the builder, even though he dug around and found all this gold, he's feeling even worse. The price of what he's offering has gone down. He's got even less revenue in total and absolute gold coins now. So when he goes to the farmer, he's like, look, I need to buy that base level of food. Otherwise, my family's going to starve. But business is worse than ever. I'm so pessimistic. He doesn't even tell the farmer that he discovered all of this, that he's hoarding all of this. And so he says, farmer, I can just afford half a coin worth of stuff. And the farmer says, well, I guess so, since the building prices have gone down, and I can buy more with that half a coin, and I have all of this surplus labor and surplus capacity on my farm. Sure, I will take a half a coin for the same thing that last year I took a full coin for. So you see the situation where deflation is occurring, even though the money supply has increased. And of course, I'm exaggerating things. And normally, if you had this large of a bonanza in the money supply, people would start to get optimistic and would start to spend money, and it probably would lead to deflation. But the main point here is to realize that it isn't just driven by the absolute quantity of the currency. That's important, but just as important are confidence and what confidence drives, and that's specifically the velocity of money, the transactions of money. The higher the velocity, or quantity matters, but quantity times velocity is what really drives the level of prices.